प्रोफेसर आशुतोष शर्मा, प्रोफेसर पद्मनाभन, प्रोफेसर विनोद पॉल, डॉक्टरेट रेणु स्वरूप एंड मेनी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड पीपल इन दिस ऑगस्ट ऑडियंस, विद प्रोफेसर पी एन टंडन, डॉक्टर एन के गांगुली एंड मेनी अदर्स, all senior researchers, industrialists, people from corporate world, investors, innovators, biotechnology people, guests, friends, media. So it's a very happy moment once again, like every year. Sixth birthday of Virek. And you must be wondering that I come on every birthday. Let me first congratulate all those who are associated with Bharat for the exemplary work that they are doing and for the significant achievements that have been seen over the years. Last year when I had come, I said, at least show what's there in the market. So the first thing that they showed me today was a big board with some 40-41 products which have already reached the market, and some 60 are in the process of, they have already been, you can say, invented, discovered, whatever you can call it, and they are now in the process of getting into the market. So it's a list of 100 products that have been produced in the last 5-6 years, and 30 business incubators of biotechnology. That's also a good achievement. I was just wondering, where do we go from here, and with what speed and with what direction? Most of my thoughts I have shared with you in the last few interactions when I came to Bharat, and I was just thinking, going forward from what, in fact, on many of the things that Professor Vinod Pal said, we are on the same page, and I think we think on the same lines. So I was wondering, you see, 2018 is a very important year in the sense that now, since last year, the Prime Minister is also talking of delivering a new India by 2022. So he's asking everybody to have a dream, a new vision, and he wants his vision and dream to be realized. And for that, he wants happiness all around. He wants all the unsolved problems of the people to be solved. He wants all the sufferings of the people to be alleviated, because there are many basic things that the people continue to suffer even after 70 years. So I was wondering that if in the current year we start with a very good quality brainstorming, which may last for maybe days or weeks, I don't mind that, with all relevant people, where you look at the overall potential of Bharat, and then list out all the problems, where the problem can be solved with the right application of mind, right development of idea, and then the right type of support for that idea to get converted into an entrepreneurship program, product, process, whatever it is. So that at least we know that these are the issues that we have to find out the solution, and we have to ensure that by 2022 this issue has to be resolved, and there has to be a solution to it, there has to be a product market which should be able to help us. There are solutions to many of the problems already there, but sometimes they are very expensive, sometimes they are beyond the reach of the common man. And as I always feel as a medical professional also, that every day we come across new technology, but as the technology comes, it becomes, means the healthcare system becomes more and more distant from the common reach of the reach of the common person, because it's been expensive,
And as soon as the technology comes, people become like slave of the technology. There's a, even in medical science, I find that after the technologies have come, nobody tries to apply the mechanism of reaching to a diagnosis which has been taught to all of us in the medical college. We are dependent on a technology to arrive at a diagnosis because we don't have time. So sometimes the thing is there, but it's not affordable, it's not possible. So at least from BioRec, or maybe say from biotechnology department, if we start with a listing of all the issues of the society which can be helped with the BioRec, and then as I was also like, as when I was sitting, I was thinking that every time we come across and meet some innovators or those who have already developed the idea, but we never meet those people whom we can give the idea that if you also develop an idea, you can also become an entrepreneur. That is where I was just wondering, if you can not even wait for the next BioRec birthday, let's have a big, huge program, 2-3 days or 1 day, say in the Gyan Bhavan, or maybe even a bigger. Last year we thought of doing a big women scientist activity. We could do it, we could bring all the women scientists and ask them to deliberate together. Similarly for those who are in the field of biotechnology, let everybody be involved at this stage and let them see for themselves, let them come, let all those problems be posed before them, and then we give them the idea that if you pick up any one of them, there is a system in the government which can help you to develop your idea into a realization of your big dream. That is, I think, probably one of the important missing links, where from here we can actually move. And last time, and I think this needs to be institutionalized now, that there is a mechanism as soon as somebody enters into the field of biotechnology. Like overall in science and technology, we are now have these programs like Manak and others, where we start encouraging students to develop innovative ideas. And we are almost generating 1 million new ideas every year now with the Manak program. And then some of these ideas, every school we shortlist 2 ideas, and then these ideas actually develop further in various directions. And then you have the, ultimately you have the Festival of Innovation, like where you have yesterday the
new significant thing, that the grassroots innovators and those who have become big entrepreneurs, they were all together. Earlier it used to be only the grassroots innovators. Now that level, up to that level, so that even the grassroots innovator also gets to gets himself exposed to the one that he also started like me, but he can also, so because sometimes these grassroots innovators, they innovate something, but they are not able to actually convert that into something big in the, all those things in the board, they may be there on the, in the market in some way or the other. But unless they are in the market everywhere, you see them everywhere. Most of the things that I see being developed in BioRec, or maybe as innovation in my own science and technology department, or in CSIR, I usually don't see them in the day-to-day life. I usually don't see them being used somewhere, you go to some place, you find, oh, it's our own invention. So, like, there is a need of scaling up all that also. So this, I think, should be the focus area, because we should keep in our mind that by 2022, whatever the extreme potential of this department is to give to this country solutions to its own unsolved problems, first we have to give to the people who can solve the problem all the unsolved problems. Otherwise, vaguely someone gets an idea, or let me do about this. Last year when I went to that function in India International Center, somebody had some innovation which was related to my own ENT field. I was very happy that he had at least thought of something which is helping and solving some issue which I could appreciate as an ENT surgeon. Similarly, I feel that there is a need for a very good quality brainstorm. My experience of last 25 years of public life is that some of the brightest ideas and suggestions, they always come out of a good quality brainstorm. That is why, and that brightest idea, it is not necessary that that brightest idea will come from the brightest intellectual. It is not essential. That brightest idea may come from a simple layman. That is why I always tell my head of the departments, whether it is the science labs or wherever I go, and most of the time when I ask them, I ask a charge of a lab that, have you ever had in your 30 years of career a good quality informal brainstorming with the people who work under you? And most of the time I don't get a satisfactory reply. There may be formal meeting, you talk something and then forget about it. But the informal quality brainstorming with virtually everyone, and then out of the various ideas that emerge out of that brainstorming, pick up the best one, pick up the few best ones, and then deliver them to few best, ambitious people, those who dream, those who need the support, those who have the zeal to put their heart and soul into doing it. That's one thing. I say that because unless somebody who has the opportunity to do that, if he is not told, what is that you can do? I fondly remember that, since Dr. Vinod Paul will be able to appreciate that, my dream of a polio-free India only came to my mind because 17 days after becoming the health minister of Delhi, some few pediatricians, they caught hold of me and told me that India is home to 60% of the polio cases of the whole world and there is a strategy. Honestly, I was not aware that there is a strategy that we can get rid of polio like smallpox. So since somebody told me, I could develop that dream. So we also have to tell someone, these are the problems around which you can develop a dream. So this is one thing on which I would like you to work as an institution. Institutionalize this. Do some big activities in the next 1 year so that at the next BIREC, you have great things which you can say surpass the achievements of the 6 years in only 1 year. But I'm sure you'll be able to do that. These three suggestions, he has talked about developing something for the wellness centers, because there also you need some quick mechanisms to be able to, and especially this encephalitis. I have seen that these children, when I was health minister, I used to visit these places in Muzaffarpur and other places in eastern UP. They'll have a blood sugar, the small children, they'll have blood sugar which goes down up to 10 milligram or so, and then nobody knows. Somebody says it's because of metabolic cause, it's because of a toxic cause, somebody says it's because of some, I mean, there's a lot of, you see, but then that 10 milligram is not detected at the lowest level immediately, and immediately that child is not shifted. So there have to be all those mechanisms. Then one issue also that I pointed out at the last one of those meetings was, which I right now I don't see it is happening anywhere, is that there is a need for institutionalized mechanism of a scientist plus a clinician plus an IIT guy. This is where I think the Niti Aayog, Dr. Vinod Paul, can probably help us and see that the people in Niti Aayog also start thinking about, because alone a clinician can also not convert his idea into a dream of providing something which is affordable and which is like handy and could help the people. Neither an engineer in the IIT, if he is not familiar with what's happening in the hospital, and then if both of them get the backing of the scientist in the laboratory, a lot of things they are happening inside our labs. If these three people get connected, but not connected as a matter of some meeting or somewhere just on a, you can say, superficial scale. Let us develop an institutional mechanism whereby the IITians, they start going to the medical colleges. We have a process of internship or something. There is a process like that. Then they also start going to the some of these labs, and these labs people or the clinicians, they also have a, those who have interest in this, obviously. So there has to be, this process has to start. I think it may not start at a bigger level, but at our level we can maybe develop a model around this, that there is a good quality day-to-day interaction and coordination mechanism. Maybe Professor Paul can help us with the help of the director aims to at least to begin with, start with, say, biotechnology people here, the All India Institute people there, and you have only a couple of kilometers away the IIT Delhi. At least these three institutions can together work out this strategy to sort of institutionalize this, and I'm sure that this will certainly yield us good quality dividends. And there's hardly anybody in this audience who knows less than me. I think everybody knows more than me about the biotechnology and what is the potential. But this potential has to be known to all those who can actually give us the real dividends. That is what I think the Bayrek movement can do. We came here and I remember I heard about the Bayrek achievements, and then I saw the, who are the people who run the Bayrek. I saw there are most of the people who run the Bayrek, they are the people who were in the government or who are in the government. So I posed that question. I again posed that question. That if the same people who, when in the government, they have a different output, and if the same people when they go into the, out of the government and they will create a system with the support of the government, there is a different output. This anomaly should also be addressed. And this is not a very technical anomaly. I think even while we are in the government, we have to be working with our heart and soul. And I think right now there is a Prime Minister at the helm of affairs who works day in and day out with a very strong jazba. He doesn't bother what people will say about him, but he is convinced that what he is trying to do is to change this country, to help this country, to see that the real people who deserve our help and support, they are actually helped. So he is taking all sorts of decisions. And by now, Professor Vinod Paul must be appreciating all this. Nobody in this country ever thought of doing an objective survey to find out which are the places in this country which are still like back, not yet developed, or they are still not served with adequate facilities, they are still backward. There is already pointed out 115 aspirational districts which need and deserve the special attention of the whole country. That's where people like Professor Vinod Paul and other Niti Aayog people, they are all involved in third party evaluation about such places, and then putting all the application of mind to help those people to at least come up to a level. This is what he did for the Northeast. When he started his career as a Prime Minister, he used to tell us every day, focus your attention on Northeast. We have to bring that part of the country to at least the level of the rest of the country. And we can now see in 4 years there is a distinct change. So what I would request, that Bayrek people, you have a definite direction in which you work now. And for those in the government also, if we also can slightly put our more of our heart and soul into this whole activity of at least ensuring that we are able to help in contributing towards the realization of a 2022 dream of Prime Minister. It will require a little bit of, I think, proactive approach, a little bit of out-of-the-box approach, a little bit of vision, and then of course a dream for each one of us to be developed. A dream which may appear to be impossible, but I am sure that if you have a really sensible and a really meaningful dream for the people of India, God is also bound to help you. So that's what I think such occasions should actually mean, and that will be the real success of such celebration of birthdays. Otherwise, birthday is like cut a cake, enjoy, and then forget about the birthday. But from birthday to the next birthday, at least there should be a dream. And I am sure that with so many investors coming in and with the achievements that you have already been able to accomplish, when we showcase all this, I'm sure more and more of people within the country, outside the country, international people, I can see a lot of international people. I wish to express my gratitude to all of them and all my respect to all of them. That I'm sure that the system is not going to suffer because of lack of support. Where do we want the support? That we have to actually pinpoint. That's the real issue. And for that, I am sure that you should have a very clear-cut target for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, and the target for 2022, when we celebrate 75 years of independence. And you say that, oh, we have solved all the problems. There is no problem. What do we now do? So that should be the real target. And I think when you have people like Professor P. N. Tandon and Dr. N. K. Ganguly and Dr. Padmanabhan and all those still active and still wanting to contribute, and there are so many others, I'm not naming everybody. So I am sure that we are bound to get success. There is no reason why we will not get success. So with all this, I think all my good wishes to all of you. And once again, many, many happy returns of the day. Thank you. Happy birthday.